All right, Jerry Jones broke out his checkbook and he wrote himself a fat check for all-pro corner Trayvon Diggs, the cornerback securing a 5-year, $97 million contract that could be as lucrative as $104 million. This is a big splash. We all knew Jerry was biding his time before he'd make this splash, and the Cowboys get Diggs locked up through 2028. This is a very important thing for him. They know they want to get this guy on the team. They have an elite defense. They feel like the window is now. He was entering the final year of his rookie contract, and good for Diggs, the former 51st overall pick back in 2020, converted wide receiver at the University of Alabama. Wasn't really sure how his career was going to end up. We know Big Brother Stefon is an elite wide receiver in this league, and the Cowboys kind of took a little bit of a risk on him. We weren't quite sure how he'd translate into the NFL. And good for Diggs. He got his bag. And it's very interesting. We've had this trend across the NFL. When a top-tier Pro Bowl, all-pro type-level player comes available, they want to be the highest-paid player at their position. It's just the way things have gone. Diggs, not going to be that. He's going to be the fourth highest-paid corner this upcoming season, only behind Denzel Ward, Jalen Ramsey, and Marlon Humphrey. So really good on Diggs. Way to get a hot top-tier contract and not totally go above and beyond, because there's some other guys on that Cowboys roster. They got to get paid. But here's the thing with Diggs. He had a massive 2021, led the NFL in interceptions, but he got cooked a lot. Gave up a league-high 1,000-plus yards in coverage, got burnt for a ton of touchdowns, and that's been my big issue with Diggs. I don't like a corner that does that, but last year he really developed into a much better cornerback, had a career high in tackles, career high in pass deflections at 14, only had 3 interceptions, which is fine. Drastically cut down the number of targets he faced, and he gave up way less yards. Career low, 12.2 yards per reception given up against Diggs, and only 3 touchdowns given up. I can live with those numbers. Now, he did give up a very, very not great 60-plus percent completion rate when targeted as compared to 2021, which was only 56%. But hey, we got to take some bad with some good. See, with that Cowboys defense, your pass rush is so good. You can't be getting cooked. Yeah, the interceptions are fun. They're awesome. You're running back for touchdowns sometimes. But that defense is so, so good. You got to be stable. You can't be giving up big plays. You can't be giving up yardage. You can't be giving up touchdowns. Let the offense score 21 to 24 points and let the defense shut everybody else down. So good for Diggs for developing his game, sliding more into that less of a risk-taker role that you don't necessarily need on a great defense. You maybe need that on a bad defense and more of a coverage-type corner. And I expect him only to get better. He is only 24 years old, so the Cowboys have him locked up through his prime. Perfect. They can move on from him in 2028 when he'll be about 29, 30 years old, right when corners start being pretty shitty. Gonna be honest, that's about the limit for corners. They don't have a long lifespan necessarily in this league. You gotta be fast to play corner in the NFL. So good for them. He was scheduled to make $6.3 million this year off his rookie contract, so he'll still be making that, but I'm sure he's gonna get a fat signing bonus. We don't have the details out quite yet what the total guarantees and stuff like that are gonna be, but I'm sure Jerry took care of his boy. And the next big name on the list he's going to want to make this splash for is obviously wide receiver CeeDee Lamb, but they have more control with CeeDee. They have a 5th-year option still with him. Diggs was the priority. Obviously, there hasn't been much talk. What's going on with Dallas? They have a lot of cap space. They weren't really spending that money. Clearly, they were trying to get this done. They're getting it done as they're rolling into training camp. Now, everybody's kind of getting into the swing of things here. So, good for Diggs. Good for the Dallas Cowboys, good for Jerry Jones, but it's still a little bit awkward. Officially today, all-pro guard Zach Martin will be holding out from the team. He has not been happy with his contract. He has voiced his displeasure with them. I did a video on it last week. You can check it out here if you want to take a look at that. He's not happy with his contract. The Cowboys have money, and so Jerry gets this deal done, but he has his all-pro guard sitting out. He will be getting fined $50,000 per day. Yes, per day, and that's non-waivable. So I don't know how committed these guys are going to be to actual holdouts when it comes to the contract situation. And I don't know what Jerry's doing. Jerry really wants to win a Super Bowl. Unfortunately, Jerry's getting pretty old. He's on the way out of things. And I think he really, really, really wants one more before he's done with this whole thing. And these are the kind of moves you have to make. Go get your guard paid. You just got your lockdown corner paid. I would be worried about Diggs holding out if they didn't get this contract done 100%. We've seen what Big Brother Stefan does. I'm sure the apple doesn't fall very far from that Diggs tree. So this is a very good signing for the Cowboys, a very critical part of their defense that they're mostly bringing back. Like I said, CeeDee Lamb's up, and then down the pipe, Micah Parsons. But this is their window. This is the year for the Cowboys. You have to make an NFC Championship game this year. If you don't make an NFC Championship game this year, it's the same old from the Dallas Cowboys. And I honestly don't know where they go from here on out. But congratulations to Diggs. Go buy yourself something nice. Take care of your boy. Everybody loves him. But again, like this video, subscribe to the channel if you're not already, share this video with your friends, and I'll see y'all tomorrow.